Greetings, saints, in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. We thank God for this wonderful opportunity to come to you and share the word of God. I'm Pastor Zwakele Masuku of El Shaddai Tabernacle International, Msokwaba Branch. Today, we'll be talking under the title that say, He is still Jehovah Jireh. He is still Jehovah Jireh. One of the name of God is known as Jehovah Jireh, which means the Lord our provider, or the Lord will provide. So today I want to encourage you that you can know God as God who provides. You can know God as Jehovah Jireh, which means is the Lord our provider. So we'll have our scripture or text from the book of Matthew chapter 6. While we're reading verse 31 to 32, when we read from the NIV, it reads as follows. Verse 31, so do not worry saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or what shall we wear? For the pagans run after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them. So what I want to emphasize from this verse, the Bible is telling us not to worry. For the first line says, do not worry, saying, what are we going to eat? What are we going to drink? Or what are we going to wear? Why we should not worry? Because our Heavenly Father knows that we need those things. So it means the Lord will provide. If God knows, He will provide for us. That's why I'm saying He is still Jehovah Jireh. He is our provider. So you need not to worry about anything, for our Heavenly Father knows that we need all those things. Sometimes we think God don't care about our earthly needs. So we read here, the Bible is telling us that He knows that we need all those things. When we read again inside Matthew chapter 7, reading from verse 9 to verse 11, the Bible says, which of you, if your son asks for bread, will give him stone? Or if he asks for fish, will give him snake? If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give good gifts to those who ask Him? So now, God is telling us to say, if our earthly fathers, they are able to provide for us, how much more about God Himself? He says, if they are able to provide while they are not God, they are able to provide because they are our earthly fathers. He says He can do more as our Heavenly Father. So He emphasized that He is the provider, that He will provide for whatever that we need. So we have to have faith that God knows what we need. It doesn't matter what we are going through right now, but we know that God will provide whatever we need. Sometimes we are facing difficult situations. Sometimes we are facing difficulties in life. We have to understand that God knows what we are going through and He will provide. When we read from the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, we see God as a source, the God who provides for His people. He is interested to provide for our earthly needs. He did it before and He will do it now. I'm sure that God knows what you are going through, and He knows what you need again. So I'm saying you have to have courage. You need to have faith and know that when you ask of God, He will provide what you need. Like as I said, that in the Bible from Genesis up to Revelation, we see God providing. We see God being faithful. We see God providing for His people. You can ask Abraham on Mount Moriah. God appeared there and He provided for Abraham and He provided the lamb. You can ask Hannah, who was barren. God appeared and he provided Samuel. You can ask even Peter, who toiled all night long. He couldn't catch anything, but God appeared and provided a net-breaking catch. You can even ask Lazarus, who was in the tomb. God provided and gave life. You can ask the Israelites, when they were facing the Red Sea, God appeared and gave them the way. You can ask whosoever in the Bible, you'll see that God surely provide, because he is the provider. It doesn't matter what you are going through. It doesn't matter what you are facing, for God is the provider. You can even ask David, when he was facing Goliath, God appeared and he gave him victory. So it's God who supplies for all our needs. It doesn't matter what you are facing, God will provide. Somebody said one day, you need not to remind God to provide for you, but you have to remind yourself that God is the provider. God will never forget to provide for you. God will never forget that you need certain things here on earth. God is going to provide for what you need. So what you need to do, you need not to remind God to provide for you, but you need to remind yourself that God, he is the provider. That's why I'm saying he's still the provider. He's still Jehovah Jireh. He will provide for our needs. He is the faithful God. I don't know what you are going through, but I'm here to encourage you that the God that we serve, he is the provider, and he will provide for you. I want to give you the following points before we close to understand and encourage yourself that God, he is Jehovah Jireh. The first point that I want to give you is to know that God is concerned about your basic needs. That's why he says, don't worry about what you're going to eat. Don't worry about what you're going to drink. Don't worry about what you're going to wear, because I know that you need those things. So point number one says, know that God is concerned about your basic needs. God is concerned when you are hungry. God is concerned when you are naked. So know that God is concerned about your life. Number two, don't worry in the midst of chaos, but have faith. Don't worry in the midst of chaos, but have faith. Have faith in God, that even if I don't see anything right now, but I know that God will never fail me. So I'm saying number two, don't worry in the midst of chaos, but have faith. Have faith in God, because God is pleased when we have faith in him, and God will act on our behalf. Number three, trust in God's perfect timing. Number three, trust in God's perfect timing. What I mean by that, the Bible is telling us in the book of Isaiah, the Bible says, when the time is right, the Lord will make it happen. So trust God's timing. He's never late, he's never early, but he will answer on time. So trust in God that he will supply your needs at the right time. Number four, apply the word of God over your situation. Apply the word of God over your situation. So it means, in other words, whatever you are going through, you must apply the word of God. If God said he will supply your needs, you must know, God, you are going to supply my needs. If God says I will heal you, you must know that at the right time, God will heal you. So apply God's word over your situation. So stand on the word of God. Number five, have your priorities right in the midst of chaos. I will say it again. Have your priorities right in the midst of chaos. It doesn't matter what you are going through, but have your priorities right. The Bible is telling us that we have to seek the kingdom of God first, and all these other things shall be added unto us. So it means your priority in whatever you are going through, it must be God. The priority, it must be the kingdom of God. Your priority, it must be your faith. Your priority, it must be the word of God. So keep your priorities right in the midst of your chaos. In the name of Jesus. Number six, learn to develop patience. Learn to develop patience. So it means, in other words, when you have prayed for something, learn to wait upon the Lord. The Bible is telling us that He will give us strength when we wait upon the Lord. But we'll only do that when we have patience. So learn to develop patience. Don't try to help God. You cannot help God. God will supply at the right time. Number seven, make all your requests known to Him by prayer. Don't forget to pray. When you need something, just communicate with Him. Not that He doesn't know, but He wants you to trust Him in the midst of whatever that you are going through. Don't complain, but pray. Don't tell other people, but pray. Talk to God about whatever that you need. Number eight, which is the last one, know that every test will pass. This is so powerful. You must know that every test in your life will pass, and God will provide whatever that you need. If you need healing, God will provide that healing. If you need money, God will provide money. He can put money in the mouth of the fish because God is able to do whatever. There is nothing that is impossible. Whatever that you need, God can do it. So the last one, that the last verse that I want to quote as I close is Philippians 4, verse 19 from the NIV. It reads as follows: "And my God will meet all your needs according to the riches of His glory in Christ Jesus." The Lord will satisfy all your needs according to His riches in glory, not according to the economy, not according to your bank balance, not according what you are going through, but according to His riches in glory. God can heal you. God can provide whatever you need. God can touch you. He is still Jehovah Jireh. He will bless you. Child of God, I'm here to encourage you. Don't give up. I know we've been going through tough times, but God is still faithful. He is still Jehovah Jireh, and He will provide for you. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Amen.